Okay, guys, welcome back to Let's Play Clock Tower. This time we're doing Intermission 2. And let's see. Okay, why are you calling her Teach? I didn't get to read half of the stuff the guy was saying. I'm usually a fast reader, but the text was going a bit too fast for me. Let's talk to Jennifer. Okay. Oh, he's human. Just a little insane. All right, no problem. We'll just go to each place like we did last time. Okay, so that's a no. Got it. Okay, so we can go here. What does this lady have to say? Okay. Do I talk to you again? Yes, that one. What other one could it possibly be? Are you sure he ran away on police business? Maybe he just ran away because he didn't want to have to deal with anything. Here, look at the mask, Helen. Nice, pretty skull mask. He did take it to the library. Don't know, don't care. Rick is of no use to us. Rick is expendable. He can die. He says, man, get him. I don't really care. Let's see. Let's try. I don't want to go to the library yet. Let's go to the hotel. Okay, we'll talk to this person then. That's right, I was. Who cares where Edward is? Shouldn't he have a chaperone? I mean, he doesn't remember his own name. He doesn't remember really anything about himself. Shouldn't he have a chaperone with him? Fine, we'll go to the newspaper office then. Quit calling me Teach, and who the heck is Rick? So you've been feeding information to the enemy. Oh. Then why would he even be really involved in the case to this extent? Exactly, nothing. No, did anyone go missing around the time that he quit? That he could possibly know anything? I mean, I understand that it's important to investigate all options, but I mean, it just seems weird to involve him into the case to this extent. But Rick doesn't have the statue. No. 'Cause it's not at Rick's house. Alright, now I guess we'll go to the library. Oh no, I guess it's scenario two, okay. Now I'm gonna save and I will see you guys next time.